England, huh? It's really beautiful, isn't it? Yeah, those Ings must be lucky people. Look at all those trees down there. Zev's gonna love this.
Zev is dead. Vlad killed her.
Yes, I know. Yes, I know Zev is dead. But Uther said the other druids that wanted the Feast of Morgoth will bring her back to life. Okay, look, I know you think it's crazy, but we gotta give it a shot. You know, sometimes I don't understand you, Kai. Zev is our friend, and sometimes friends are all you got. But look, Vlad was seconds away from killing you up there, and I saved your life. That's what friends do.
You did not save my life. I am dead, and Zev is now also dead.
Look, if there's the slightest chance that we can save her, we've got to take it, okay?
There is no need to cover her ears. She cannot hear us.
Just fly, okay? This doesn't look right. Where are we?
We are approaching our destination.
I think you took a wrong turn.
These are the coordinates.
Are you sure you know where you're going?
Yes.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna call 790. 790. 790.
790.
Yes, my scrumptious bundle of corpse.
Respond to Stanley.
I would rather not.
It would be helpful to me.
Very well, I will listen to him, but I'll be thinking of you. What is it, worm face?
790, I think we're lost.
You, Stanley Tweedle, are always lost. You are an anal wart in a universe of beauty spots.
Uther described the feast as taking place in a forest called Glastonbury. We seem to be heading into a densely populated urban center.
And there are trees in a forest, right?
Kai, you are right as always, and right for me. But I gave you new coordinates. I found out that the feast has been moved this year due to an airborne cattle disease in the countryside called foot and mouth. Although the only airborne disease I'm aware of right now is called Stan the Tweedle.
So what is our destination?
A city called London.
Thank you, 790.
Just a minute. And just where do you think you're going?
Feast. Morgoth. It's here, right?
No. It's the bloody 4th of July. Of course it's the Feast of Morgoth. And why are you dressed like this? You're not the Mincefields? These aren't the Mincefields, are they, Marjorie?
They most certainly are not, Colin.
In which case, you have to pay to get in. And you have to be properly registered, card-carrying, dues-paid members of the British Druids Association, which is not part of the Celtic League or in any way associated with the so-called International Federation of Real Druids.
Look, that's all very interesting, OK? But see, we don't have to be a member of anything because Uther sent us.
Could it be?
Time will tell.
Uther? Never heard of him.
Well, sure he did. He's famous. He did that song, what's it called, Kai?
It's Magic, Magic Baby.
What do you mean, Nigel Bumpson? So where is Nutty Nigel this year? What's happened to old Barmy Bumpson, then?
Well, he's dead, actually. Vlad killed him.
Oh, what a terrible loss for skiffle lovers everywhere.
So, you're the ones Nigel says he's been searching for all these years, eh? Well, I think he could have done a little bit better. I mean, your dark man's about as menacing as a fluffy little squirrel. Your dead one is the least convincing corpse I've ever seen. I mean, Where's the blood? Where are the black eyes? And as for you, yes, I do admit, you do make quite a convincing fool. Nonetheless,
And just what is that?
I was an assassin of the Divine Order. This is the weapon I normally use to kill people.
Oh, no, hold on. It states very clearly in the Druidic Code, paragraph 86, statute 16A, Druids may not carry weapons. You are permitted a small knife, blade no longer than 1.6 inches, for herb-gathering purposes only. I'm going to take your cards back, people, if you have cards.
Let them in.
Oh, my God, you're him. You're Tarquin Fullstaff. I've seen you on Cults of England. You're the renegade druid.
I know not of whom you speak.
Yes, you and their Uther.
Let them in.
Yes, fine.
Hey, thanks for helping us out.
Don't drink the mead, Red Fool. Thee neither, Dark Man.
I think he likes who, Fool?
If you're not Tarquin Fullstaff, who are you?
Mead delivery.
Did you hear them talk of Uther de Glastonbury's death?
Yes, tragedy. He served as well.
Us?
By us, I mean, of course you, my queen.
Queen?
King, I said king.
I want to see the chosen one.
You cannot. You must remain in the sack.
I don't want to. It's dark and smelly in here.
She never was much good in the sack.
Very good, my queen. Thank king.
It's so terrible. Duh, I'm so stupid. I can't even stand up. Duh. Thank you, Mr. Darkman.
Your thanks are worthless to me because I have no soul at all. I am a walking hollow shell of a man waiting to be filled with joy and worship.
Duh, you also have a silly haircut. Silly, 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 silly.
What a dumb show. Who's that red guy supposed to be anyway?
Excuse me.
Yes? Oh.
Can I be your lusting partner?
What's a lusting partner?
You get to spend the day lusting over me. Then I latch onto a dark man for the rest of the evening. And I lust after him, ignoring you forevermore. The way it's supposed to be.
No, actually, I already have a lusting partner.
Oh, well. Guess I'm too late. Happy feast.
Hey.
Hello, everybody. Hello, everybody. Thank you. If you could all don your hoods, please. That's it. Thank you. Hello. I'm Colin. Colin Hamilton Smythe. Good to meet you. I will be conducting proceedings today, telling you what to do and when, all that kind of thing. Okay. First, a little history. What are we doing here? Well, the Feast of Morgath, or Mograth, as it is sometimes known, is, as we understand it, the ancient druidic feast that celebrates the wedding of the King of the Forest. We hold the feast every year, but believe that once every 1,500 years is a special feast in which the King of the Forest marries a new bride that we druids present to him in a ceremony blessed with magic. The oral tradition of our druid forefathers teaches us that the next bride to be presented to the king will be known as the Dead One, and she will be accompanied by the Red Fool and the Dark Man. And after careful selection from one of our largest ever fields of contestants, the College of Grand Druids are proud to present this year's Dead One, Red Fool, and Dark Man.
Hexfield family. Okay, everybody. Let's hope this is a year for some real magic. A toast to the Red Fool and the Dark Man and the King's bride-to-be, the lucky, lucky dead one. Are all the cups filled? Even the children's? Okay, everybody.
Remember, don't drink
this
it.
This is the start of an amazing night. Charge your glasses. O Feast of Morgoth. May magic appear to us this eve and feast with us once more. Cheers, everybody.
Cheers.
Cheers.
All right. Cheers.
Now the fun begins.
Hmm. Impressive. A truly thoroughbred fool.
Told you not to drink the mead.
Oh, what's mead? Oh. What's going on here? Who are you guys?
I'm the reason this feast happens at all. It's thrown in my honor.
You're Morgrath?
No.
You're Morgrath?
No, there is no Morgrath. They merely started calling it that 12 centuries ago. We're not sure why.
Okay, so who are you?
This is Oberon, King of the Fairies. Your master. I am Puck, the king's manservant.
What was that?
What was what?
The king's manservant.
Just a little cough, my king, an innocent little cough.
Oh.
Let me out! Let me out!
No! Dark man, no.
What did you stop him for, idiot?
I'm sorry, my king, but it's only a matter of hours before you're finally free.
Free from what?
I can't wait either. I want to find myself a real man.
My soon-to-be ex-wife, Titania.
Oh, what a foxy dark man. He's the best I've ever seen.
Look, I don't know what the hell is going on here, but we were sent by Uther.
Did Glastonbury, my most trusted knight. He searched the earth for you. Never has a man responded so valiantly to his calling.
He told us that there was somebody here who could raise the dead.
Well, he hasn't made the dead rise for me in nigh on 2 centuries, if you know what I mean.
Silence, woman!
That is correct, Red Fool. I am entrusted with that ability from time to time. Take me to your dead one.
Wow. Isn't she something special? Kindest of faces, softest of skin. There. Done.
Kay!
Oh, Siv. Siv, you're alive. Oh, my God, I thought we'd lost. Oh, we're so glad you're back.
Where are we?
We are on the Earth at Uther's feast.
Uther? He was killed by Vlad.
Vlad is no more. Stanley killed her.
After she killed me.
Yes. You were dead. We brought you here to bring you back to life.
We? Hey, less of the we stuff, okay? Guy was gonna give up on you, but not Captain Stan.
Thanks. I'm glad to see you both.
What a touching, beautiful scene. I actually think I'm going to cry.
Now, listen, we gotta thank you guys. You don't know what we would have done without you. We really appreciate it, but we got Zev back now, so we're just gonna go.
Your gratitude is unnecessary. You have nothing, and you are going nowhere.
Huh?
The one you call Zev shall be my bride tonight.
Kind of greedy in the wife department there in Japan. You got a bearded one over here.
She is my replacement.
Pipe down, whore. And you, Dark Man, will join my chorus and rejoice in me eternally.
The dead do not rejoice.
We shall see. What shall we do with the little red fool? Huh? Perhaps he will be my lapdog for 1,500 years.
This is a Type 13 planet in the final stage of its cycle. It does not have 15 years left, let alone 1,500. We will leave this place.
You will do exactly as I tell you to do, Dark Man. You belong to me now.
If you do not allow us to pass, I will kill you.
Really? Kill, you say? I'm intrigued. Are you intrigued, Puck?
Fascinated, my king.
Well, let's see what you've got, Dark Man. I will not allow you to pass. Oh, little sweetie, and what's your name? Little Tweety. What do you think, little Tweety? Do you think I should let the Dark Man and his friends escape? Even after they tried to kill me, which wasn't very nice now, was it? What's that you say? Well, since you asked so very nicely, I suppose I will. I will give you until the sands of time run dry to leave my forest, or else serve me forever in my kingdom. Is that fair, Puck?
More than fair, my king.
More than fair. You're free to go.
Trees in England grow fast.
Climb, climb, sing with us. Climb, climb, sing with us. Join us in our song.
Ah! Oh. That hurt.
Trees do not normally do that, do they?
No, and that's not all they don't normally do.
Climb, climb, sing with us. Join us in our song.
Hey, you're dancing.
I am aware of that. I seem to enjoy it.
The dead do not enjoy dancing.
Under normal circumstances, I would agree with you.
Kai!
It's Oberon.
Kai, Kai, sing with us! Join us in our song!
What have you done to Kai?
He is fulfilling his destiny. He has joined my chorus, as every Dark Man must. His empty black soul has been filled with the purest of love and joy for me.
Set him free now.
You can be a bit more persuasive than that, dead one.
I'm not dead anymore.
Only because I choose for you not to be so.
790, 790, can you hear me?
Hello, sir, can I help you?
Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. Listen, my name is Stanley H. Tweedle. I'm captain of the Lex, okay? Now, there's some guy named Oberon, calling himself the King of the Fairies. He's taking us prisoner in some woods, okay? Now, somebody's got to come and rescue us because Kai's out there, he's dancing with some singing trees, and they're going to make me into some kind of a dog, and they're going to make Zev marry Oberon.
Well, that doesn't sound so bad to me.
What, are you crazy?
No, the sooner Zev marries Oberon, the better. And I'll no longer have to put up with his stupid pigging face any longer.
Ah, shut up, wench. You're no flaming oil painting. Imagine waking up every morning for 1,500 years to that hairy yak.
Drunk old clown.
Yeah, of course I'm a drunk. I've been married to you for 15 centuries. It's enough to turn anybody to drink.
You poor petal. You must be petrified.
Why?
You're about to wed this beast of a man.
I will not marry you.
Insolence!
Temper, temper, my king! Think of the meadow. Think of the meadow and all the little bunny rabbits. Yeah. Remember the bunny rabbits?
I like bunny rabbits. I like them a lot more than I like her.
They don't like you. They told me so.
You don't speak bunny.
I took classes. There's lots of things about me you don't know, and you never will.
Good, I don't want to either.
Fine.
Great.
Perfect.
My highnesses, we are so close to the time of parting. Could we please not just get off? Good. Now, I shall prepare the bride for her duties.
King of the fairies.
No one believes in fairies any longer. A fine job you're doing.
I will not marry that man.
You don't have a choice. The best thing you can do is just go along with it.
What if I don't?
He will make your friend suffer. And he'll make you suffer too.
I won't do it.
You know, it really isn't all that bad, you being a fairy queen.
How do you know? Have you been a queen?
Chance would be a fine thing.
Why me? I mean, what does he want with me? I'm hardly like Titania at all.
You're the chosen one?
Oh, great.
You are a fat, old, smelly, hairy, ugly, ungrateful, worthless, boring, clumsy, pathetic excuse for a disease-ridden bastard son of an inbred whore and her festering, brainless brother-in-law. And you want to know why I married you? It was because I was drunk! Drunk! Isn't that right, Puck?
Whatever you say, my king.
I don't know how you can say that.
It's easy. I just move my mouth around.
How you can live with yourself?
It's a damn sight easier than living with you.
You can be so hurtful.
Yes, I can. And I can say whatever I want because I'm the bloody king! Right, that's it. I've had enough. It's over. This marriage is... over!
Over unhappy are we few. Dark men whose days shall end singing praise to you.
Kai! I think we gotta get you out of here.
I appreciate the gesture, Stanley, but it is not necessary.
What, do you want to be a tree?
I do not want to be a tree. I am a tree.
Dark men whose days shall end singing praise to you. Over on.
Kai, we have to go.
I understand that, Zev. I will remain here.
We won't leave you.
Come on, Kai, snap out of it.
He doesn't want to leave. He's quite happy. Aren't you, darling?
Yes, very happy.
As will you all be. You have my word.
Oberon, tra-la-la-la-la.
There's no escape.
Good old Oberon and sweet Titania. Oberon, dancing in the field. Tra-la-la-la-la-la.
Oh, there. Don't cry. You made her cry, you big bully. Look at what stage she's in.
She is no longer my wife, and you must learn to respect me as she never did. Stop blubbering, woman.
Well, I missed the good times.
Good times? What good times? There were none.
There were some, weren't there?
Were there?
Perhaps one or two, but that was a very long time ago, and we must look forward, not back. And besides, you're my bride now.
Why?
It is the way it is, as it has been since before time began. Many moons ago, I was king of more than just the forest. The planet was mine. The bond between the human world and the fairy world was strong. The druids populated this land, and they held me in high esteem. Oberon worship wasn't annual. It was hourly, it was constant. They were my subjects, I was their king. My followers have been reduced from being the proud leaders of strong nations to the smelly kid at school with the bad haircut.
Each feast gets worse and worse. Look at it now. They pay to get in. And use this as an excuse to meet other losers and drink cheap mead.
Well, it's not even proper mead. They just mixed 12 crates of lager with a drum of golden syrup. I dread to think where the next feast will transpire, if it transpires at all. I'm a good man. I humbly request your hand in marriage.
Nice sob story, pal, but I don't see anybody here crying into their hankies. Come on, Siv, let's get out of here.
No. What is it like to be queen?
Come, I shall show thee.
What's that?
That is our castle, and below it, our kingdom.
It's all so beautiful. So magic.
If you marry me, You will rule by my side for 1500 years, and then live on for eternity as a beautiful flower in my kingdom.
You've enchanted me, my king. But I detect a sorrow. Do you not love me?
Of course I do. You're beautiful. And you have large breasts. I want to do naughty things with you.
Well, then you'll have to catch me.
Young love. Takes you back, hmm?
No, not really.
Don't be such a man.
This is crazy. How can she marry that guy? She can't marry that guy.
Why not?
Well, because it's wrong.
Look, to be honest with you, I agree. I mean, she's not exactly his type.
What, are you kidding? I mean, look at her. How can she not be somebody's type? I mean, if she's not his type, who is? But I thought he said he married her because he was drunk.
Those wretched Romans used to say that in drink there was truth.
You mean he's the kind of guy that likes other guys? He...
Let's just say he's king of all the fairies and leave it at that, hmm?
Him?
Mm-hmm. I'm your real king.
Yes.
Then conquer me. What will happen to this place when your planet is destroyed?
Even now, I do not have the power to destroy a planet.
Some do. And it will happen soon. Will it affect this place?
I do not know. Perhaps this will be my last marriage, the one that will last for eternity.
I will marry you.
You will?
Yes. But I have conditions.
What are these?
You have to free Kai and Stan.
I see. Is that all?
No. You have to be nice to Titania.
I have to be nice to no one.
Then you don't get to marry me.
Then I will not marry you. Another bride with no respect. That hairy beast deserves everything she gets. You know nothing of it. You know nothing of the centuries of hell that I have had to endure. As for your precious friends, I shall not release them or you because I don't bloody have to.
Because you're the king?
Yes, because I'm the bloody king.
Yes, my king, but the sands run quickly through the hourglass. Perhaps you should reconsider. Without a queen, you will no longer be a king. You have to marry somebody tonight, be it Zeb or Titania again.
No, Puck, I don't. I can marry whoever I like. Be it her, or him.
What?
Lucky you.
What, he's letting us go?
You are being offered the opportunity of a lifetime, Red Fool, the chance to be a real, legitimate fairy queen.
Queen, no, Cece. No, I don't want to be the queen, okay? I'm happy being the Red Fool. Ah!
Kai, please, we must return to the Lex. We're all we have, and we at least have some sort of life there.
Kai, we must get away from here. If we don't, we will be stuck for 1,000 years.
Zev, the B3K, join us in our song. After all, 1,000 years isn't very long.
You should join him.
Thanks, but I don't want to be a tree. Neither does he. He's just being manipulated.
Well, we're all being manipulated, sir. Trick is to make it work for you.
I will not be a tree. Neither will Kai, and Stanley Tweedle is not going to marry that man.
Who's going to stop him?
Me.
Can't allow that.
Listen to the forest king and Titania.
Oh,
overrun. All the bells will ring.
Overrun. All the bells will ring.
Stanley
Tweedle shall be wed to the forest.
Overrun. All the bells will ring.
Overrun. All the bells will ring.
Stanley Tweedle shall be wed to the forest.
Welcome to my paradise, Stanley.
Wow, it's beautiful.
I know.
What's that?
That is our castle, and below it, our kingdom.
Oh, it's magic.
If you marry me, you will rule by my side for 1,500 years, and then live on for an eternity as a beautiful flower in my kingdom.
Well, I can't say that all this doesn't look tempting.
Good. It will be a blissful marriage.
Blissful. Well, you're not saying that there's going to be any naughty business in this marriage, are you?
Oh, yes. Lots and lots of wonderfully naughty business.
Fairy King.
What is it, my love?
Well, you see, it's just that this may be just a little bit more than I might want to get into, you see. You know, your flowers, your castle, the kingdom, all that. That's just fine, you see. But the kissing, the naughty business, that's just not me. You see, Stanley H. Tweedle goes in the front door, or he does not go to the party. You know what I mean?
Oh, well, that's okay for you. But my portal of preference sometimes is the back door. So you don't want my ring on your finger?
No.
So be it.
Yeah?
Well, that's the way it is.
Okay, well, I'm just glad to see you're taking it so well.
That's absolutely fine.
Well, okay, then. Glad to see you're taking it like a good sport. You're a pretty good dancer, too. Yeah. Hey, where's Zev?
Ah, well, you see...
I'm right here.
Ah! Where'd that king guy go?
He went away.
Oh. Yeah? So, you're not getting married, huh?
Yes, but not to the king.
To who? To Kai? He's a tree!
Not to Kai. To you. If you'll have me.
Yeah, right.
I know it's a bit sudden, Stan, but maybe this is our only chance to live on forever together. Give me your hand. In marriage.
How come, after more than 4,000 years of you turning me down every single time, do you suddenly want to marry me?
I know! It doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
It's completely crazy.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or maybe it's completely sane, but I also think it's our only hope to get out of here. Marry me tonight.
Just a question before I say yes. Is there going to be any sex in this marriage?
Absolutely. Lots of hot and naughty newlywed sex. Promise.
Yeah? Well, okay then. So, are you really sure about this?
Absolutely. Hot,
the newlywed sex? Yes?
All you want.
All I want. It's a lot. Okay then. Let's do it.
What's he doing with that red fool?
Marrying it.
Oh, hot, dead body.
Puck.
Come, my queen. Let us go and get some fresh air.
I don't want to go.
And leave these lovebirds to their musings.
I should go and get myself ready for our wedding.
Don't be long.
I won't.
Oh, what has he done to you, poor, poor things?
You are not happy. Join our chorus. It will make you happy.
Yes. Sing our joyous song with us.
I wish that I could, but I can't. I'm a past queen. My future is set.
What is your future?
I will become a flower in Oberon's meadow.
That is so romantic.
But I don't want to be a flower. want to be. A woman.
But then you must do something.
Yes, Kai is right. You must do something.
Oh, you're right. I must do something. And I will. No one knows Oberon's devious little mind like his, Titania.
Why can't I just wear my own hat?
That's an ancient tradition, darling. Hmm. And I must say it suits you.
Yeah. Hey. I warned you about that.
My hand slipped. Again. Hmm. How do you feel?
Well, I feel kind of, I don't know, pretty.
Are you comfortable walking in high heels?
I'm proud to say no.
You should practice.
Hey, Dada! Who? Huh?
Oh! Oh!
What have you done to us? Kai? Is that you?
Yes.
You said you'd help if you could. I need you both to act as Stan.
The dead do not act.
If the dead want to get out of here, the dead are going to have to learn. You'll be fine, but just remember, don't act it, be it.
Be it.
Well done. Let's go. We haven't got much time.
Have you got brothers?
Huh? Ah! That's me. It's Dan. It's us.
Who?
Zev and Kai. Oh, no. No, Zev is outside getting ready because she wants to marry me.
That is not Zev. That is Oberon.
Well, she looks a lot more like Zev than any of you.
But it is not Zev. This is Zev.
Oh, yeah? Well, how am I supposed to believe that you're the real Zev? Ask me to marry you. Okay. Will you marry me? Absolutely not. I never have, and I never will feel that way about you. Not if you are the last man in the two universes. Yeah, well, that certainly sounds a lot like Zev. Yeah, well, trust me, Stan, or you'll marry Oberon, and you'll be stuck here forever.
Don't listen to them, Stan. This is Oberon, trying to trick you out of a marriage with Zev. Trust only your instincts, Stan.
Pook!
Stanley, do not trust your instincts.
Yeah, Stan, that's a bad idea. Okay, no, just wait a second, okay? Look, I just gotta think for a second, okay? Now, you see, on the one hand, I could have some red-hot sex with Zed for a while. On the other hand, I could have an eternity of naughty sex with a big, ugly guy. Ooh, I think, Stan, the man's starting to have a certain level of discomfort here.
What is this? I demand to know what this is. Who is my Puck?
I am your majesty. No, I am my king.
I believe that I am my king.
Who is doing this? Titania, is it you? Who is in whose body? No. This is not fair. I demand the real Stanley take a step forward. No!
We are running out of time. Such treachery, such deceit. All right. If that's how it is to be, I accept your challenge. The one who did not step forward must be Puck.
At last.
I do not want to marry Puck because I am king, and he is a mere fairy. I do not want to marry the dead one or the dark man either. I would like to marry Stanley, but I do not know which of these three bodies he inhabits. The most important thing is that I do not marry Titania again. So, I will choose at random from these three
who must be Stanley, Zev, and Kai. You. Wait a minute. I've missed something. You think I'm a fool, do you? Tanya, I know you. Knowing that you are the last person I want, you will have discarded your own form, taken someone else's shape, and put poor Stanley in yours. Ha! You can't fool me, bearded wench.
My king.
Silence! Do not try to alter my decision. Goodbye, Titania. It's been a miserable 1500 years for both of us. For you, there's a flower in my meadow, perhaps. Or, more likely, a mushroom on my dung heap with your name on it. For me, the moment has finally come to be joined in blissful matrimony with a new soul. No.
And this time, it's forever.
All's well that ends well.
Good mead this year. Huh. Oh, my God, look at the time. We've got to get out of here before Battersea Council charges for a second day. OK, everybody out. Out. Yes, well, don't dawdle. Hurry up. Yes, yes, goodbye. See you next year. Come along, come along.
That has got to be the worst Feast of Morgoth I have ever attended. And I've attended a few stinkers, I can tell you.
Yes, I do have to say it was totally lacking in magic. Still, you know what that means? Roll on next year.